were put in the physical body. The physical body came from the earth. The spiritual body comes from nowhere. The Jews came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, questioning him. In our scripture, in the Torah, we were told a little bit of the spirit, but we are not given the real thing. We want to know what the spirit is, so that we can look longer, so that we can find. Like many researchers in universities, they are working very hard. Who will invent or find a way to stretch the life of man? Never. You can never do that. You can look after the body, cut it, research it, transplant it. If we are in Islam, we have no problem with transplants. We have no problem with blood transfusion. We have no problem, whatever you want to do with the physical body, do it. As long as it does not harm the person you are using, or it makes quicker, okay, his death or his suffering, then you kill him. Otherwise, you can do it. Why not? If it will help him, do it. Research it. Fix it. No problem. This is Islam. This is religion, generally. So the Jews came to him and said, O Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, if you are the true Messenger, tell us about the spirit. Our Messenger, peace be upon him, never give an answer from himself. He will always go back. And he left us by telling us, never give an answer from yourself, O my followers, but always. Remember, I have left you two things. The Book of Allah, the manual that will tell you about your soul, physical or spiritual, and how to live in this world, and how to save yourself for the hereafter, and the way I have lived it. My sunnah. To many, the sunnah is just the hadith, the saying. Bukhari, Muslim. No! It contains the entire sunnah, the complete sunnah, which is his doings, his sayings, his approvals. Everything he did, everything he said, and everything he approved. And we can go on this for a long time, but that's not our importance now. Our importance is to realize at the end of the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this Quran gave answers. And the answers are there for those who will think, who will ponder. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was waiting for the answer from Allah. He said to the brothers who came to him from the Jewish brotherhood, please, my brothers, wait and we'll come with the answer. They were waiting for him. He called him, I have received the answer. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. I seek refuge in the Creator Almighty God from the devil, from the evil one whom Allah has raised, a rejected God, and he was brought down to this earth, who has managed to take us away from the past, to think only selfishly to that which will benefit us rather than that which will benefit others, and raise us from our humanity, being physical to being spiritual. He, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said to them, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And they ask you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about the spirit. Tell them, it is of the order of my Lord. And remind them, you have only been given of the knowledge that which is very little. Very little. We cannot go further. So when you see somebody who saying, well, I have seen my spirit, tell him you are a liar. When someone said the spirit is made of this or made of that, they are a liar. Show it to me, bring it to me. There is nothing. I sometimes laugh. Many people are taken for a liar. But somebody will say, okay, excuse me. Yes, I think, yes, he's here now. Where is he? I can't see him. No, no, he's here. He's talking to me. Adil, Ibrahim, Jacob, he's staying. It's beginning with J. And the person, because they're vulnerable emotionally, is he saying Jesus? No, it's not Jesus. And then they just make it up. And we believe it. How sad a man with a faculty to understand and to create and to initiate and to invent and to do good things just following rubbish. Why do you that? Why do that? Or even worse, somebody opening a magazine, oh, my star said, don't walk in this road. Nonsense. I knew a friend of mine, very clever man, who used to write the stars for an Arabic newspaper in London. And when he has trouble, he comes to me. One day I asked him, but you write all the stars? I just wake up sometimes so late in the morning, I just write anything. People are just so dumb. They believe anything. They pay me for a job. But that's the reality. It's all nonsense. Allah said in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ وَحَمَلْنَاهُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ. And indeed, we have honored the children of Adam. And we have allowed them to be able to exist and live on this earth and do anything they want or on the ocean. But yet, we do not come to the understanding. My dear brothers and sisters, please leave me tonight not having all the knowledge, but at least having the light to go and rethink and research. Ask yourself four questions. Who am I? Who am I? Many of us don't know who are we. Am I this physical body? Am I this mud that was made into flesh and blood? Who am I? Where do I come from? Have I always existed in this earth? What am I doing here? Just to get up in the morning, for my father to shout at me, for my wife to tell me off, for my husband to give me a headache, for my teacher to fail me, for my boss to sack me. Everybody's having all those troubles. What kind of existence is that? And then suddenly fall ill, be miserable, and suddenly perhaps go to prison, being beaten up, being abused, and then suddenly you die and that's it. None of us wake up in the morning and go to the work for nothing. We plan things. We organize things. We build things. There is a purpose for everything we do. None of us do something for nothing. Otherwise, you are all intelligent people. When you finish your education, go and do nothing. You will all tell me you are crazy because you all want to earn something, to gain something, to do something. And therefore, our creation is not for nothing. We are here for a purpose. But what is it? Why are you here? Why are you existing? Ask yourself a question. And the most important question, when I am going to be put in that hole on the ground 2 meters down, 2 meters by 1 meter, if I'm lucky, or half a meter, and my beloved put mud over me, and they leave me, cursing me, fighting over my inheritance, taking one another to court, neglecting me, forgetting about me. Can you imagine Bill Gates? He was so hard, and all those billions, and he's down there. So for what? Or any rich man, for what? There must be a reason. Where are we going to go next? Ask yourself that question. For your life, you are insuring yourself. You are insuring your car. You are insuring your home. Everything is insured because you want to make sure whatever you work hard for is looked after. What about your hereafter? Or you don't believe in it? Well, if you don't believe in it, there is something absolutely wrong, because that you should think about. That one who created us has just created us for fun, for a joke. And that's it. Finished. Just like I looked at the tsunami picture in Japan, and I looked at the Japanese as being the most adventurous people in creative mind, making all the world. We're all worried now where the computers are going to come from. They've got a lot from China. The best minds in the world for the last 100 years have been these Japanese people. Very clever people. They made everything. Some of them are sitting there thinking, what we have invented and built, nothing can destroy. And some of them who are naive enough to say, even God cannot. Yesterday, their beautiful creation was just dumped like toys in a field, and your mother or sister came with her bucket and threw water over it. Nothing left for the child but to cry. And everybody's crying, and I feel sorry for them. And all of us should think of that as a lesson, not for them, but for us, who are sitting comfortably here under this beautiful building, having this dry land, having our beloved children, wife, parents, uncles next to us, and we are having a school to go to and a job to have. Please, 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 I beg you, think of yourself as a noble creature. Not in the physical format, for if it is by physical means, the human being is not the most agile, is not the one with the best sight, is not the one with the best hearing, is not the one with the best strength of body. Can you be more stronger than your horse? Never know. Can you be more sharp in the smell, sense of the smell than your dog? Otherwise, we'll all be working for Scotland Yard. The smell and the sniff drives. They will not have a job. We are the weakest when it comes to physical creation. But yet, we don't think about it. The dog is more clever. The donkey, whom we say, oh, this is the donkey. Believe me, those long ears like radar. Once there is a rain coming, there is a storm coming, they will run for it. Yesterday I saw Japanese who were driving towards the tsunami. Once they saw the water coming, they turned around before they even managed to turn it fully, the car gone. But the horses and the animals are long the way gone, saving themselves. Who's clever then? Who's wiser then? This is the thing that can say to us, look, land! And then